A $7 million house, 3 YouTube channels, Daquan and Hamblins, and an entire group of close friends. The formula for any successful content house. That is what NRG expected. However, the reality is quite different. Almost nobody streams, false promises are made, the internet in the house was terrible, and their last upload was 2 months ago. It has been a complete scam. And Daquan and Hamblin seem to have disappeared again. So with Daquan's last known appearance in the Thum House hide and seek video, and him still not being found 2 months later, there is only one question to ask. What happened to Daquan this time? To answer that question, we need a little backstory on what is going on with the Thum House. Basically, the Thum House is a mess, and it plays a crucial role in Daquan's disappearance. Luckily, we have a fan channel called NRG Thum Short shining some light on the situation, and this will help us find out what happened to the house. First of all, not many viewers are interested in the friends of Daquan and Hamblins, causing them to live in their shadows and act as fillers. And NRG actually acknowledges this, as their YouTube channel only shows Hamblins and Daquan in the title and thumbnails.
However, people have noticed with the titles that it's like, hey, Hamblins and Daquan, Hamblins and Daquan, Hamblins and Daquan. And also the same for the thumbnails, but they tried to change it up a little bit on the hide and seek video. They weren't the main focus. Everyone had pretty much equal attention. I mean, Day's picture was a little bit bigger than everyone else's, but that doesn't matter. They changed it up a little bit, tried to shine a little bit of spotlight on everyone else, and the video didn't perform as well.
Second of all, there seems to be miscommunication with the NRG Thum House editors. Clips are requested to be included in final videos, but don't actually end up getting in, causing viewers to lose out on potential funny content.
A lot of good clips that have been shot were not added in the YouTube videos. And at the time, we had no idea.
Then, another point is that when the people in the house do actually stream, it's usually low energy. Now, this doesn't really matter when you occasionally feel less energetic, but when you're a part of the Thum House and you don't really Thum that often, it kinda gives off a misleading image.
I'm not saying that you have to change your personality. If you're a chill streamer, cool, you chill in your house, you do your stream, you do your dailies, you do whatever you do on stream, I'm not here to judge you. However, if I'm a member of a Thum House, I'm expecting to have a high energy personality, not just, we're gonna be chill today, guys, just gonna be relaxing, throwing some tunes. I don't want that every stream. It's okay if you're not feeling it that day, but at some point, turn up. It's a Thum House.
And ultimately, Hamblin's viewers get bored with every single thing he does.
The chat on Hamblin's stream tries to bully him into doing what they want. They'll put Z's or resident sleepers as if they can't just click off if the stream is that boring.
Internet in the house was terrible, causing the lack of streams. There is still no podcast, and late uploads turned into the complete wasteland that their channel is today. Fans are angry, and rightfully so. Everyone deserves a second chance, but not a third one. They're living the best life and take it for granted and ditch again. So ungrateful. People would kill for this opportunity. Boys got the bag and dipped again. As you can see, Daquan is slowly starting to lose respect from the community. And this isn't limited to the NRG Thum House YouTube channel. When we look at the replies to his latest tweet, the hate and disappointment continues. I'm so tired of him and Ham coming back for a little and then leaving. Just tell us you're not interested in streaming. You're doing more harm not telling us than you would be. Just be honest with us. Have some transparency with your community. And do you blame them? They waited over 2 years for the return of their favorite streamer. They finally got what they wanted with a spectacular introduction, and then got left in the dark again 2 months later. So why is he not giving us any updates? Well, according to Twitter, there are two potential reasons. You have one group of people claiming that it has something to do with his mental or physical health, and that we should be compassionate, while the other group of people claims that it was simply a cash grab and that he doesn't care. I personally don't know the reason as to why he chooses to not give any updates. However, I do know why he disappeared. Now, there are many rumors floating around on Twitter as to what Daquan is up to now or why he disappeared. Let's take a look if any of these are true. First of all, user JoshCats has been replying to many tweets that he is simply playing Call of Duty right now and not even streaming it. This would be pretty disrespectful towards his community, and quite concerning if this happened to be true. Josh said that Avery was streaming and that Daquan was playing with him. Now, when we look at the streaming question, we can actually see that Avery does in fact play with someone named Quan, and he does sound similar to Daquan.
Hello, I'm back.
Welcome back.
Oh, Daquan's back. Hey, baby.
What's up, baby?
I'm inviting you.
Oh, no, I eat.
Oh, okay. I'm not inviting you.
But something felt off for me. Sometimes he does sound like Daquan.
You hit first prestige too?
While other times he doesn't.
Like the challenges were half finished.
So I decided to do some research. I contacted P1 Jason, one of the players that was in the squad, and asked him if it was actually Daquan that he played with. Well, the answer was no. He was simply one of his homies and got asked that question plenty of times. However, he is in fact not Energy Daquan. And we also have his Twitter account to verify this. So now that we know that it's not true, let's look at another lead. This is where a guy named VibesWTF comes in. He claims that Daquan disappeared because of the internet in the Thum House, as it's absolutely terrible. And we actually know that this is true. The state of their internet has been discussed by many of their members and has also been labeled as the main reason for the lack of streams and content. However, at the end of November, Energy Philly stated that the internet issue was fixed and that the Wi-Fi was fine.
We are okay, you know, Ethernet is fixed. Wi-Fi is fine.
So why is it that we still don't see Daquan streaming or any Thum House content? It has been more than a month already after the internet has been supposedly fixed. This is clearly not the issue. It was looking like we hit a dead end with our research. That was until I saw a tweet from Carbs. He said that Daquan is getting new streaming equipment and that the delivery time is taking very long. Now this is definitely true, as EnergyXE did actually confirm this as stated in the tweet.
He is working on getting his IRL set up, because he wants to IRL stream but he can't. So yeah, that's what's been going on.
We were now finally getting somewhere. Daquan listened to his fans as they found the IRL content boring.
Daquan's first stream back, he had a nerf war, he was having fun with his friends, and although very few, some people called it boring.
And now wanted to IRL stream. But he couldn't do it because he was waiting for the streamer backpack. However, it's been almost 2 months again. So what happened?
And speaking of Day, it seems like that backpack that they ordered actually arrived like a long, long time ago. And they're doing plenty of testing to make sure it's ready to go. But how much testing are they gonna do? How much?
Okay, so Daquan received the streaming backpack, but was doing testing with it and is currently working on issues.
There's so much things that are involved that needs to be like set up, and we don't have like the resources. We don't have the resources and help to do that. So we gotta figure it all ourselves.
So they claim that they have to do it all by themselves and that it's the reason for why it's taking so long. But don't you guys have an entire organization backing you?
Energy not helping at all. They are helping, but they just don't have like, they don't have the resources. Like, I mean, they got the money and everything to help us out, but they don't have like knowledge about IRL things.
Okay, so Energy apparently has no knowledge on IRL things. I find this weird, especially because Grady, the executive producer of Energy, has been seen using a streamer backpack himself. Even if he landed this from Arab, another IRL streamer, then they could have still used his contact to fix Daquan's backpack, since Arab had issues with his backpack as well, but got them fixed by somebody. This could be a case of major miscommunication between Energy and the Thum House members, but for me, things don't seem to add up. If Daquan truly got this streamer backpack and is working on it, then why is he not updating us on his progress? Is it really that hard to put out a tweet confirming that you are still working on it? Any piece of information would do at this point. Also, are editors really taking more than a month to pile together clips for a video? Surely, with a great team of experienced editors, it shouldn't take that long to release a video unless you are planning something big. And why do Daquan and Hemlins avoid the cameras, as they weren't involved with Thumsgiving either? We all understand that you want to visit your family during Thanksgiving, but when the entire house celebrates it together and Daquan and Hemlins are missing, it looks weird. These questions will remain unanswered. But to give you a final answer as to what happened to Daquan, he got a streamer backpack, is working on fixing it, and videos are being made. When are the streams and videos coming? Nobody knows. Hemlins has tweeted Merry Christmas a few days ago, and Energy also included the Thum House with Daquan and Hemlins in their Christmas tweet. Which means that Energy has definitely not given up on the Thum House nor the contracts of Daquan and Hemlins, as they otherwise wouldn't have included them in their tweets anymore. However, I think that they will return at the beginning of the year. At least, Hemlins will. It could take longer for Daquan to return, as he hasn't tweeted anything nor given any updates. But he needs to do something soon. Daquan is slowly losing his legendary status, with many people already having lost respect. And if he waits a lot longer, then this might be the end of his legacy. Now this was the reason as to why Daquan disappeared again. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like on it, subscribe if you're new. I hope you had a great Christmas and a great upcoming new year, and I will see you guys in 2022.